amen, to people around us. Oh, praise the name of God. But I'm here to tell you this morning that God cares about you. Oh, praise the Lord. I don't care what you have done. I don't care how long you have stooped. The Bible is letting us know that God's hands are not waxed short, that he cannot save you. So whatever the situation is, whatever the challenge is, the scripture says cast all your cares on God, because what? He cares. Oh, praise the name of our God. That's why when David was going through, amen, he said, lift up your head, all ye gates, and be lifted up your everlasting doors, and the King of glory shall come in. Who is this King of glory? It's the Lord strong and mighty. It's the Lord mighty in battle. It's the Lord that cares about all of us this morning. And we, you know, when we read this scripture out of Esther, amen, here is another example. Amen, God running interference on behalf of his people. Amen, most of us know the story, amen, you know, about Esther. Amen, how God, amen, took the young lady, amen, rose her all the way up till she was the queen of Persia. Amen, and in the end, she ended up with God's help delivering God's people. Amen, but as I read through Esther, amen, not only was Esther one of the main characters in this book, but Mordecai, amen, was another main character. It was Mordecai, amen, who was a cousin who raised her as if she was his child. It was Mordecai that encouraged her. It was Mordecai that nourished her. It was Mordecai that stood behind her, amen, when she needed support. So much so, amen, that she, when she got to this position, amen, that she was, that she didn't know at the time, at some point, amen, she would be able to return the favor. But I thank God, because even here, amen, Mordecai, amen, we know the story, Haman, and this goes all the way back to the book of Exodus, when God brought his people to the promised land, and he told them to destroy all their enemies, the Amalekites. But in other words, they left some of these folks around. So as a result of leaving some of these folks around, years later, amen, some man by the name of Haman, amen, now looked at God's people with revenge, thinking about the history, just like we hear about the history in the Middle East. No matter what we do, folks are going to be at each other forever. So here was Haman, amen, who got promoted to a position, and now was in a position, amen, to really to try to destroy God's people. Amen. So he kind of ingratiated himself to the king. You know, giving the king, giving him all these pleasantries and telling him how great he was, and also telling the king how he could basically increase his wealth. Praise the name of our God. So the king, amen, like some of us, amen, somebody telling us all these things, hey, you know what? This person really has my best interest at heart. This person really wants to see me do well. Amen. This person really wants to add to my what? My stature. So he basically told Haman, you know, in essence, just do whatever you need to do. Amen. But what the king didn't know was, amen, that Haman sought, amen, to destroy God's people. And praise God, because as we pick up the story here, amen, in the sixth chapter, and this is what I talk about, God working behind the scenes. After Haman had already went to the king, had already, you know, told him this plot that they were going to end up killing the people, they was going to get more money, amen, here was king. That same night, the scripture said the king could not sleep. Praise the Lord. Amen. Usually, amen, the king had his choice of women. Let's be honest. He had everything that you could want, everything that a man could desire. He really had no challenges. He really had really no issues. Yeah. He could just beckon someone at his call. And even if someone was to come into his palace, amen, unannounced, that person would be killed. So the king really had literally nothing. So I could just imagine that every night, he went to lay his head down to sleep. He had no issues. Probably was able to get his good 8 to 10 hours of sleep. Amen. But on this never honored for such a great feat that he had done. Amen. So the king said, wow, we got to honor this man right away, because that was the tradition at that time. If someone did something, you honored them. So here comes Haman, all coming along, chest poked out, thinking that he's going to get all this royalty bestowed upon him. And as he's entering into the gate, amen, before Haman could get a word out of his mouth, you know, it's just like, think about, amen, and I hate saying this, if I'm walking to the pastor's office, even if I got something on my mind, I'm going to defer and say, okay, pastor, what would you like to say? Amen. Just like if we go to our parents or we go to the principal. So this is what basically Haman did. And then when the king started telling him, what should we do for someone that basically did a great deed and saved the king's life? And then, amen, Haman said, we should bring out, amen, the royal robe. We should just give this person everything. We should have him ride on a horse. We should just have him, you know, just put him on display. Yeah. Amen. And just when Haman thought that the king was going to mention his name, he said, you know what? This is what we need to do for Mordecai. And here was Mordecai, amen, you know, sitting outside the king's cave, amen. And then Haman had to basically go and do everything that he had said, all the splendor, all the great things. And although I did read it at the end of this chapter, it was said that after Haman did all these things, he went home and spoke to his wife and, you know, one of his other relatives, and they basically told him, you know what? You're going to fall because this Mordecai is of the Jews. So why am I saying all this? I'm saying all this to help you to understand that God still cares. Yes. God is working behind the scenes in your life. I don't care what may come. I don't care what may go. I'm here to tell you this morning that God is still on the throne. And God cares about you.
Yeah.
About your loved ones. Yeah. Oh, praise the name of And there are times that God cares more about one another than we care what? About one another.
Yeah.
This is what this thing is all about. You know, we said earlier that God so loved the world that he gave.
Yeah.
Amen. Not only did God give his son, amen, after he gave all of that, the scripture says, I gave some, amen, apostles.
Yeah.
He said, I gave what? Some prophets.
Yeah.
I gave some evangelists.
Oh, yeah.
I gave some pastors and teachers.
Yeah.
Why? For the perfecting of the saints.
Oh,
for the work of the ministry.
Yeah.
For the edifying of the body of Christ.
Yeah.